Christian, Silverstone, it's not the Grand Prix circuit this year, it's the national circuit, but we're down at turn one, which remains the same.
Yeah, we're on the national circuit, which is a bit like a wobbly triangle, really, if you look at it from above. So, not a lot to it, but that means we've got to make the most of everything we've got. So, yeah, we're down at turn one, exactly the same as what it is normally for every other race weekend. No one, I think, or not many of us have ridden this new surface, so it remains to be seen how that's going to fare, and also the curbs, because normally you'd run down these curbs, or you can certainly run on them, and you can even brake on them. Get this first corner as wide as you can. It's kind of a blind entry, because the barriers are quite close on the inside, so it's always a difficult one, and it's always been typically very bumpy in the past. And the same with any corner, really, at Silverstone. There's no camber, so actually getting the front turn is the main bit, and then it's one of them where you always run in, you think you could have gone through it faster, and then you try and go in faster and you run deep. So the key to this one is really just getting on the gas early. The track really opens up on the exit, and it's a nice long run to the next corner. Yeah, we're at the Maggots, Beckett's, whatever else complex. We've lost the whatever else bit now, so we're just sort of Maggots, Beckett's, I'm guessing that's going to change. So typically this would be fifth gear and then just back one for the fast right kink that you can see. You basically ignore the fact that there's a left kink, so it's usually straight across the curb. I don't really think the entrance line's going to change. We'll see tomorrow, but it's pretty much a big funnel. And usually it's actually, everyone funnels in quite nicely because it's a nice flowing corner, but this is going to be a way bit different because you're funneling into basically a much slower corner. I anticipate this is going to be at least third, if not second gear corner. So this is the new one. This is the interesting bit of the track.
This is where we turn onto the new section of track, I guess.
Yeah, this is basically the new part of the track. I don't even know if it's got a name. I don't know if you'd call it whatever it was called before. So yeah, this is new for everyone. I'd say this is the first time. I don't know how long it's been since we had a new track. Maybe Mondello in BSB was maybe the last time we had a new track. Since this is a brand new track to BSB, so this is the bit that makes it interesting, I guess. There's a bit of touring car racing they race on this track, and the line is actually, because this first entry bit is quite tight, but then as you can see, it sort of opens up in the middle and then goes again. So it'll be interesting to see what the line is. It's probably going to be a case that you're going to end up running almost past the first apex, run out a bit deep, and then probably midway across the track on the exit. But that's really hard to tell until you've ridden it. The only thing that is a little bit interesting is that this is sort of like kind of a link road almost. So there is a couple of patches where camber, it's not much of a camber, but you know, it sort of changes a little bit. So there's a couple of little bumps where it changes from one track to the other. So that's going to be interesting. Then how much of the track we use on this outside, there is that curb's got a bit of a berm to it. So if you go a bit wide, you've got something to bounce off. But we'll see. This is the interesting part of the track. This is what's new to everyone.
Yeah, this is the exit back onto it. I think this is probably one of the most important bits of the track, because we've got a very long straight. So this exit is super important.
Not only have we got a very long straight, it's leading into what I anticipate to be the strongest passing place, the biggest break zone. So this is super important, this corner. Getting out of here well is going to be a real key to the race. I've got no idea where the line's going to be. I anticipate it's actually going to be sort of like a mid-track position, just by the way that corner opens out. The only interesting thing to note is, because this there's no curbs on the outside, so whether the cars don't go that wide either, then I'm not sure, but obviously a bike line can differ quite massively to a car. We'll see how we get on. We've just come down the Wellington straight, which is now the longest straight on the circuit. You'll be fifth gear, just clipping the limiter probably, and then you're going to end up back to second. Really long brake zone. And the entry phase is really, really long, so you stay on the side of the tyre on the front for a really long time. That's why you see so many front end crashes into here. And I'd say this is probably going to be the main passing place. And obviously, with it being so close to the end of the lap, this is key. Yeah, so goes on forever. Big long right-hander. You're just trying to get around this first bit as good as you can and try and get the bike stood upright. Essentially, you actually don't get upright at all until you get to the start finish, but it is two corners, so the last one's a kind of a real fast kink. So this is actually a passing place. You can actually dive up the inside of people here.
and you can be a bit cheeky maybe and sneak a line. So we've seen a lot of passes here in the past. So it's not a main passing place, but it is a cheeky one, so it's possible. This is probably my favourite corner in the country. It's just epic. Basically, you come into it so fast that you're never going to make the corner, ever. But you get your drift on, and so the bike turns from the rear, and this is where you get some really cool pictures. And when you watch on TV, it doesn't look that much, but when you come here and you know you've got to commit, it's fourth gear and it's pretty much wide open. You have a bit of a roll as you tip in, and then you just give it the big load of gas and hope she goes. So it is cool. In the past, I've ended up using a fair bit of inside curb because it does give a bit of grip, and it can help you turn. So it's a man's corner, this one. I enjoy it, and it's a great last bit. We've seen some good finishes because it's a nice fast running. You can actually sneak it to the line. So yeah, if you get this right, then it's pretty cool.
So just to summarise, it's a shorter version of Silverstone. We're expecting about 52, 53 second lap times. It's going to be quite full on, isn't it?
It's going to be crazy. I mean, BSB's always been known for being close, and because this track's not very technical, that closeness is going to go to a whole new level. So it's nice and wide, so the racing's going to be good. And obviously, it's a big weekend in terms of showdown stuff that's going on, so I expect an awful lot of elbow action.